It's been a long time. 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 Big Baby's been really busy taking care of business, so I have not forsaken the community. I did do some sewing, so I'll show you in New Jersey some other time. But right now, I'm gonna do this vid here. Big shout out to Neil. Neil inspired this video, so let me go and get off to it. But first things first, let me show you what I'm rocking. This is my all-black Chicago Bulls Michael Jordan jersey. Triple stitch, Bulls, 23, NBA logo, jock tag, 1997-98, Michael Jordan, size 56, of course. Jordan, triple stitch on the back, 23, stitch on the back. Mention that snapback, still got my tags on it. That's how we do in the D, Neil. So let's get to the video, shall we? Here's a review. Mitchell and Ness is redoing these jerseys. This is an original run. This is a Big Baby's personalized custom. So let's review this one first. This is a Chinese made one. Size 60, NBA logo, 23 double stitched, filmed, inked on, jalapeno, star, basketball, double stitch, NBA, double stitch, all stars, jock tag, the date, February 11, 1996, Michael Jordan, size 60, Jordan double stitched, 23, of course, with the upside down too. I'm not for sure if this is the first run. I'm thinking it is. I thought they were made in the USA, but I'm not for sure, so don't hold that to me. This is an older run, so therefore I'm keeping my number two upside down. Like what Neil said, the upside down stamp with the airplane. Keeping it like that. Now, with the Big Baby's personalized customs, heat press Bulls, number 12 heat press. I decided to keep the Nike jock tag, number 12 on the back, heat press, double heat press, film, thermal film. I seen on Instagram that Mitchell Ness is making this one. So yo, I'm online. It's been a long time. It's been a long time. But it seems that it was double stitched instead of heat press. That's a no-no. Now for the commentary. I remember when Mitchell Ness made this one here. And they also made the Sean Kemp and a few others in this particular year of the All-Star game. Spanking hot jersey, very expensive. When they brought those out and they sold out of them, the sellers or the buyers who bought those jerseys and the sellers who got some, they jacked the price up about 70%. You could have probably got that jersey on Mitchell Ness site for $300. But I've seen them go as much as $600. This one. Just recently, they released the blue All-Star jersey. But in that particular jersey, it was limited in size. They didn't have a 60s. That's the one I would have went after. The largest size they had was 56, but they were all sold out. By they being all sold out, I just went on eBay. And went on eBay, know what I saw? Come on, dog! I'm not paying that much for that particular jersey. I just weighed out like I did that one. So big ups to Neil. He got him one of these, and he got another one coming. Now for the number 12. Mine's not perfect. To be honest with you, the arch is a little too deep. Another thing is too, the number one has an arch in this one. On the original, it was straight. But I'm cool with that. Now, if Mitchell Ness do get it right, I consider getting one. But if they come out with it and it's stitched, not buying. Why do that? You can buy a Kirk Henry, much cheaper. Strip the name off, and you're all good. But if Mitchell Ness make it right, it has to be ink pressed or at least film pressed. There's one more thing that I want to address. I think it's unfair for people to buy jerseys and buy them all out for $300 because they got the money to do that. And then go on Amazon, eBay, and jack the prices up by 80%. That's wrong. I wouldn't do that. Here's my advice. Jersey heads, don't be thirsty. What you want to do is wait it out. That's the thing about being a true collector. The item you want, you'll wait it out. Remember, things are only worth how much you're willing to pay for it. I'm not going to tell you how much I paid for these jerseys. Let me just say this. Straight up steal. Pretty much for free. Okay, jersey heads. Spend a minute. Let me get back to what I've been doing. You'll be seeing videos from me real soon. Until then, peace and shalom. Time. Rockin' the microphone solo. It's been a long time.